There is no place like home. Dorothy said that. Dorothy, who was in Oz and clicked her heels 3 times and left Technicolor to get back to that little house on the prairie with Auntie M and the mean woman who wanted her dog. I always wondered about that. Really, Dorothy, that's where you want to go? You want to go back there? Because to me, it looks more fun in Oz. But clearly, Oz wasn't home. And all that Dorothy wanted was to be home. Different religions go different ways with this. Some religions say home is in the sky after we die. There's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Others, like Unitarian Universalism, really fix our lot here on this earth as we wander, as we look for home. We and other faiths, like the Jews, don't believe that there's some other world where everything will be reconciled. And so I've been born and I stay with this concept of home being this planet, this place, this broken, beautiful world. Sometimes I wish I had another belief. And I don't feel self-righteous like this is the right belief. I understand why the people in West Virginia, where I grew up, sang songs about home being somewhere they didn't know yet, because what they had known of life was so hard in so many cases. And for people who are taken from their home, I imagine the life of African-American slaves, the Africans who suddenly didn't have a homeland, yearning for a fixed place, yearning to believe that there is a place where there's justice and reconciliation. I also want that. I want that. And sometimes when I don't see it here on earth, I desperately wish that I could believe that that reconciliation happened in some other place, in some other world. What does it mean to be at home? What does it mean to you when someone says, make yourself at home? I hope you'll feel at home here. For me, I often think that that means to be comfortable. Oh, make yourself at home, make yourself comfortable. I grew up in a housing development in Charleston, West Virginia. It was a couple of acres of split-level houses that had been plunked in the middle of what had been woods. And we kids, of course, loved to play in those woods. And when we went down the hill far enough, we would come to a shanty town. Now, I suspect that before everything was bulldozed and our houses were built, probably the shanty town was much bigger. But it never occurred to us that we didn't own that land and that those people in the shanties needed to kind of step aside for us because we had these brick houses, these nicer houses, these 50s houses, and they had shacks. Some version of that happens everywhere, all over the world, where some people believe that they're at home and other people with more privilege come and say, you thought this was your home? Oh no, I want it now and I'm taking it. That's why the notion of comfort causes me discomfort. And the same is true not only of my physical dwelling, which I'm now uncomfortably wrestling with the fact that where I live, where I bought my house, where I own it, where it's mine, actually, the land was taken from the native people, probably illegally, and I am a squatter. Just as I've come to feel at home in that discomfort about my physical place, my home, I've also come to distrust the notion of comfort as a marker of a spiritual home. We say week after week, in one way or another, that we hope that you will find a spiritual home here. For me, that does not mean I hope you will feel completely comfortable here. In fact, I think if we're not making each other uncomfortable, if we're not bumping against edges and differences and other kinds of people and other kinds of thinking, then we're not, in fact, at home. We're just comfortable. Comfort and home. These two are so woven together. And I think that that biblical myth of perfection, Eden, and us being kicked out makes us believe that what we want to get back to is that kind of perfection. Why set ourselves up that way? Why not accept that we are wandering together, together, and that even in our wandering, we can find a sense of home, a deeper place, a place where we belong. You know, Thomas Wolfe, the American writer, said, "You can't go home again." And that's certainly true for many of us who try to go fit ourselves back to some place that we used to be in our own lives. And I think it's also culturally true that we can't go back to some idea of who we were. I keep thinking, oh, that'll change soon. I'm going to fix this or change that. And then I'll relax and draw back. But I finally concluded that no, this place of change, of eternal change, this for me is home. That may be different for other people, but for me, accepting that about myself meant that I quit trying to fix it. I quit trying to solve a problem that turns out not to be a problem. It turns out just to be who I am. I live on the edge. I belong on the edge. That is my home. I think of the story of Joseph Shabala. He was one of the principals of the long-standing South African choir, Ladysmith Black Mambaza. And when Paul Simon found them and they made the album Graceland back in the 1980s, Shabala came to New York City to tour with Paul Simon. He was in a taxi cab in New York City, feeling so completely away from home, so completely out of place, and yet knowing even if he went back to South Africa, he might not be able to see his children again. He might not be able to be reunited because of apartheid, because of the oppression there. And he felt so profoundly not at home anywhere that he made a song, a prayer for himself. And it goes, Tula klazia nale pasai kaya. I may not have gotten that quite right, but it means, be still my heart. Even here, you are at home. And I believe that that process of stilling our heart, coming into our heart, can teach us to be at home, which is a really different concept than owning a home, having a home, believing that home is ours. To be at home, to inhabit our heart, takes us back to that old saying from Anonymous, home is where the heart is. And when I believe that home is where the heart is, then like Dorothy, I'm always going to be clicking my heels three times and saying, there's no place like home. May you follow your heart. May you claim your home wherever it might be, in whatever city or countryside. May you know where you belong. May you find home in one place, so that you can know home every place.